How many people do you think Bob Arum deal with?
Oh.
Or Al Heyman, how many people do you think he deals with?
Tons.
And I bet you there's those that are headaches, but he still has to deal with
Correct.
There, Bob Arum, same thing. You know, Bob Arum has had very differences with some fighters where they hate each other, but then a few years later, they're back working together.
Yeah, no, he said once something, I'm going to paraphrase his quote, Bob Arum said, you don't hold grudges in this business, but himself. But he's in a position where he needs to work with everybody.
So Canelo must have a good reason. You know, I don't know if it's common with Golden Boy, but they might also have, you know, where they hold grudges on some people, some certain people that, oh yeah, you know, we wouldn't want to work with them. If you have the fighter, you know, top rank, Al Heyman, Max Room, they're business people. If you don't work with certain manager or certain trainer, but they got a badass motherfucking fighter, you want to sign that little dude.
Yeah, right? That's true. Right.
You want to sign him because that fucker could fucking do big things for your promotion.
Change your whole promotion.
But then there's promotions, and I'm not saying that's the case with anybody else or Golden Boy or anything like that, but it might be where there's certain that they don't want to work with.
Yeah, no, I've had that where a fighter calls me, wants to work with a certain promotion. I'll call the promotion. They say, we don't like his coach. We don't like his manager. We don't deal with him. Sorry, I don't care how good this guy is.
Exactly. When those fighters could fucking change your company around.
Yep, correct.
There's a lot of times where those fighters could change your company around.
By the way, Shakur's going to be a free agent in July. What do you think he does? He's tremendously talented. He's a 3-division champion.
Well, I'm pretty sure he wants to look for those big fights, man. You know, there's huge fights for him, you know, with 135, 140. Maxwell could give him big fights at 140. I think
PBC.
Al Heyman,
yeah, Tank, PBC, Ryu.
Yes. That's probably that to, for those big
Pitbull.
Huge fights. I think PBC is probably his best option because, like you just mentioned, Pitbull, who's a world champion right now, could fight at 135, 140. He's got Tank, who could also fight at 135, and that's a huge fight. So there's a lot of big options for him. You know, I really don't know what's going to happen with him. I know he's got one more fight with Top Rank in July, and after that, he's a free agent. So PBC could give him good fights. But Eddie Hearn also, I guess he could make good offers too,
yeah,
because he just signed Boots.
That's true. You mentioned Tank. Millions of people love Tank. Within boxing, there's a lot of people who don't like Tank. I don't understand why. He doesn't bother anybody.
I don't know why. I don't think there's a reason why you're not going to like Tank.
But they do hate on him a lot.
I don't know why.
Why do you think that is?
I don't know.
Right. Why does Tank get a lot of hate? He doesn't bother nobody. He doesn't.
Yeah, he's never had anything where...
people have anything better to do sometimes.
What happened?
Some people just don't have nothing better.
Oh, bitter.
They have preference, you know?
Yeah.
Because I'm saying he might be their favorite fighter, so, you know.
Yeah, it could be.
Yeah, because I haven't seen him or anything where that's the reason people might not like him. You know, if we go to right now Canelo, there's a lot of reasons why people might not, because he's not taking the Benavidez fight, because this, because that, because, you know, Mayweather, same thing, because, you know, you didn't want to let Maidana wear the gloves, because this, because catch weight, because whatever it is. But Tank, I don't think there's been something where I could say there's a reason why people might not like him.
But it's only in boxing. 11 sellouts in a row.
Yeah, he
1.3 does. Million
he
does, pay-per-view.
He does.
And he's very
really
quiet.
Good gates.
He's like Pacquiao, where Robert, he's not active on social media like that. He doesn't do anything wild.
He doesn't do anything out of...
No, he sticks to himself.
Yeah.
He does really good gates.
Yeah.
So
I've been in his fights, and always overpacked,
yeah,
oversold. And now he's fighting Frank Martin. Do you know Frank? Has he ever seen him?
I don't think I paid too much attention to him, honestly. He's a great fighter, I think. You know, I've seen a little bit around about him, you know. He's young, he's dedicated, he's hungry to fucking become a champion. So it's not going to be an easy fight for Tank either. It's going to be a very competitive fight.
Ryu, what do you think? You have a sparring?
I'm going to see Murataya versus Shakur.
Who?
Murataya. But I don't talk about him enough. I think he's a big problem.
Shakur called you. He was on FaceTime with Robert. He told Robert, I'll bet you $100,000 that I beat Ray. And Robert said, I'm willing to bet $100.
I don't have $100,000. I don't have that kind of money. What the fuck's this problem? I told him, bro, you make millions. I don't. But anyways.
But even if you made millions, I don't think you would bet.
But the thing is,
you
that
don't gamble.
I don't gamble on my fighters. But anyways, you know, that's a different story. We wanted that fight for the July. You know, he's gonna fight somebody with a lot that just lost his last fight, which I think is kind of like, why the fuck would he fight somebody with a loss? But he was honest too. He says they never offered him the fight. I
believe him.
I do believe him too. I did bring it up to Top Rank. Hey, Muratai is available. We know that's his, you know, his date. Muratai is available. But he says they didn't bring it up, and I also understand Top Rank too.
The business.
It's their last fight with Shakur. So why would they feed him one of the, you know, their own fighter? You know what I mean? So I also understand Top Rank. I'm not mad at them. I'm not mad at Shakur for not taking the fight either, or not bringing up Muratai. But I think Muratai is ready, man. People only us that we know. You know, Ryo just mentioned him. You know. He hasn't had that opportunity to show what he could really do. That fucker's he could fight, man. That fucker could fight. And I think the better his opponent is, the better he's gonna perform. He does it here in the gym, you know. Ryo's here to tell you, he's very difficult to,
He's tough, real deal, man. And I think nobody wants to mention his name for a reason, But every time I get a chance to, I tell people in the interviews, man. Keep an eye out for him.
Yeah,
he's also very quiet.
Never on social media, never does anything like that. He doesn't even like media workouts or media days. He doesn't like none of that. He'd rather not even show up.
He just wants to win. He's focused.
Yeah. So, I'm not talking bad or anything about Shakur because this is his last fight. So he also, okay, fuck it. This is my last fight with Top Rank. Give me the easiest opponent out there. I'm a free agent. I go to bigger things. That's something that I
know the guy he's fighting. It's not easy. He's a former Olympian. He fought Frank Martin, and that was a great fight.
Yeah, but Frank Martin beat him, right?
Yeah, that was a very good fight.
Yeah, but he beat him. Unanimous.
By the way, Ryan Garcia right now, Robert, he just called out. Guess who he's calling out?
I don't know.
Terrence Crawford. I respect Crawford for what he has reached, but I want to kick his ass just because. Let's effing go.
Right now, Ryan has to. After Haney, if he beats Haney, then he'll fight Crawford and it'll be a huge fucking fight. Crawford will love it because he'll make a lot of fucking money. But he has to beat. He has to beat, what's his name? Haney. He has to. Or else nobody's going to want to fucking watch that fight. He has to beat Haney. And it's going to be hard for him to beat Haney.
Canelo says that if he fights David Benavidez, it's a lose-lose situation for him. When I beat him, they're going to say, they put a rehydration clause. It's lose-lose. I could fight any fighter, make good money, and I could do so.
See, at the point that Canelo is right now, he calls those shots. And he doesn't have to fight nobody that people are asking. I think it's a fight that we would love in boxing. Because I would love to see it. And that would give Canelo a lot of respect. A lot of fucking fans would support him. Even if he lost. But he might even win. But even if he lost, he would still get a lot of love and respect from people. But I also understand Canelo. He's got the power to say, fuck you guys. No. I ain't giving you guys the fight. You guys don't have... He's already worth so much fucking money that he doesn't need an extra 10 million. An extra 20. He doesn't need that.
Doesn't make a difference.
Doesn't make a difference for him.
And you know what? It's funny. I talked to David last weekend in Vegas, and I asked the dad, Jose. I said, "Hey, $200 million for you, $200 million for your son. Is there a fight?" And the dad said, "No, we'll take minimum to fight him."
What's his name? Same thing went on with when Mayweather was calling shots. You know what I mean? It's just the way boxing is. They're at that position where motherfuckers call the shots, and they say who they fight and who they know who they say who and when it. And everything.
Bless
you. Thank you. It's just the way it is.
I will say this. One thing that Ryan is talking about that's getting under Devin's skin, all the talk about Diddy. Being in Diddy's pool, putting the picture.
I don't even know what the fuck's going on there.
I don't know either. But Haney apparently did a t-shirt of Ryan taking a knee from the tank fight. And they served him with a letter, cease and desist. Like, hey, you can't be taking other people's property. But for some reason, I'm saying fans haven't really gotten into the fight
what's
yet.
Going on with Diddy and...
The latest, he's in Miami, free. I don't know what's going on. But they raided him, and there's... You never partied with him. No. Ryu, you never partied with him. One time when I was working at Channel 11 here, one of the producers told me that they're doing specials on these celebrity sex parties. And I'm not joking right now, I'm very serious. And guess they showed me the list of guests who's going to be there. And Tyson Fury was on the list. Yeah. He didn't show up that night, but he was on the list, Robert.
And you can't, you couldn't even believe it, huh? And then they have fucking little kids there?
That I don't know. I know, but...
I'm just saying because that's what's going on with that island or whatever.
Yeah, you know? Oh, Epstein.
So I don't know if that's...
Is Epstein still alive?
He died, didn't he?
They said he committed suicide in his cell, but no one... The cameras were off. It was very weird.
So maybe he didn't.
Might be in Brazil somewhere.
Maybe. He could be in TJ, at Delitas or something. Or Hong Kong, chilling.
Maybe he's just chilling somewhere where nobody fucking knows who he is.
Yeah, but the good part is, Robert, from boxing, we have a lot of big fights starting next weekend. What after that? Do you have Ryan fighting, then Virgil, Jose, Oscar Duarte is going to have a show. I mean, JoJo's not easy.
Then you got May 4th. That's
May 4th, Canelo, that's the following week. Then May 18th, Gio.
Yeah, May 18th.
He's fighting for the interim WBO title.
Interim WBO title.
What if Crawford stays at 147 and fights him?
I don't think he is.
Why not?
I don't think he is.
Do you like that fight though? Him and
no, the thing is that Crawford is not doing that anymore, Elliot. That's when it's like he's the big star, the big name. He's not looking for no fucking
stay
no,
busy.
No. He wants the huge and Gio's not a big payday for him. You know, he's looking for the big, huge fucking $15-20 million paydays.
Is he gonna Gio's
not a big payday for him. So he'll just leave it like that, you know, and Gio will be the WBO champion and he's not going to fight. It won't happen.
So there's a chance he may never fight if he doesn't get the dream fight up. If
he doesn't have to. In Nebraska? Yeah. The fucker's, he's made. He done it already. He did it.
I think he bought, I'm not joking, Robert, 40 homes.
Fucking good for him, man. Fuck yeah. Just think about it. I don't know what rent is over there, but if it's $1,000, that's $40,000 a month for the rest of his life. And plus... equity in the house. Every year you fucking raise the rent. Shit. He said, fuck.
Yeah, no, he has said he made it. And you have to be proud of people that came from nothing.
Shit, we're happy to see a fighter say, we already bought our house. I already bought my first house. We're already happy when we hear that. Because there's a lot of fighters that end up with no house. You know what I mean? So we're happy to hear, oh, I bought my first house. There's this, you know, Crawford, you know, nah, he's done, bro. He's good. He doesn't need to fight. Last time I talked to him in Vegas, that Teofimo fight,
fight,
he told me in Pita, he's like, what the fuck am I going to? Nah, I'm fighting only if I get the big fight. I live good already.
Yeah, and he always trains, he's always in shape. Yeah.
Fuck that. He lives good already.
So if he comes back, it's only like a freak fight. Mayweather suggested that he fights David Benavidez.
Nah,
what do you think?
David's stupid, man. Too fucking big.
You don't think it's not a good fight? He has no chance.
Too big.
Canelo is not too big?
Canelo's not tall. I think Crawford and Canelo are probably the same height, or maybe Crawford's a little bit taller. So that's a more competitive fight. Benavidez is too fucking big. Benavidez is going to end up fighting in fucking heavyweight. It's
a big actually, he had dinner with Oscar, and one of the subjects that came up was so him fighting Zurdo or Cruiserweight.
Cruiserweight.
That's it. They sparred. I was there when they sparred. It would be a big fight, Rob.
That's a badass fight, and then the winner moves up to heavyweight? Fuck.
David could do it. James Toney did it. Roy Jones did it. And they weren't as big as David.
And you know what? The thing is that not too long from now, maybe a year from now, the heavyweight division is going to be open. Because whoever wins between Fury and Usyk might retire. And they're going to leave the titles vacant. One title is going to Anthony Joshua. Okay. There's three more. So they can move up, because the champion, if you have a belt, you can move up and go straight into a title fight for the same belt that you have.
That's true.
So they do that, and they could become champion against somebody that's not very talented, because when somebody's undisputed and they vacate, there's eight people that are going to get an opportunity. Not all eight are fucking pound-for-pound best fighters in the world. Maybe one or two are very talented, but then the other ones are not that good. So there's so much when a champion vacates their undisputed belts, not everybody's that talented when they become champions.
You know what comes to mind when you're saying this? Rey Murataya against Kambosos. What would happen in that fight?
Bro, Kambosos is fighting Loma.
Does he have a chance?
I think Loma's gonna win.
I agree.
But I would love Loma to give us an opportunity, but I'm pretty sure Loma's also at the same situation where he's gonna look for the huge fight, big payday.
Which maybe is who?
A unification. If fucking Navarrete also wins, Navarrete's fighting for the title on the 18th. So if Navarrete wins, him and Lomar are gonna have a huge fight. And
who wins that one?
I don't know. It's tough.
And who wins, Ryan?
Or I would love Navarrete also to give us a chance against Mordaza, but I don't see that. I don't see them doing that. I think they'd rather fight each other to make a huge payday.
Is it easier to fight someone like Navarrete or harder? Because he's so weird.
He's too awkward. He's too difficult.
Throwing punches like Chino.
It's too difficult.
And then I asked you before, Fabian Maidana, you turned him pro, right?
Yeah.
People don't know him at all, Robert. He doesn't fight nothing like his brother. You can't compare.
He's very talented, yeah. Man. That fucker.
He hits hard.
I don't even know when the last time he fought. Let me see.
I do remember that he was in the Argentinian national team. And now he's
fighting. Amateur.
Amateur. And now he's fighting Mario Barrios and on the card of Canelo. Did you
for
know
the
that?
Title.
I saw that. They were fighting.
For the title? For the interim WBA title?
See, Fabian's talented, bro. And he's a talented dude. But, you know, there was always that question about his discipline.
Who's training him?
I don't even know. He fought last year, so yeah.
I don't know. Makes sense. Did he fight in Argentina?
He fought three times last year, so that's good.
Back home, though?
Huh?
I haven't seen him physically in years, so I think he's just.
I don't know. He fought three times last year, so good for. So that means.
Anybody we know?
I thought he hadn't fought in a while.
Yeah. Anybody we know?
No, nobody we know. Okay. No.
But what do you remember from him, Robert? Does he hit very
talented.
Hard?
He's very talented. He's got good skills. Uses his jab very well. But, you know.
Barrios is not easy.
Barrios is tough, man.
It's interesting time. So. Your plan for this week? Do you have any fights this week?
We have Luis Correa fighting in Corpus Christi. But I'm not going to that one.
Okay.
I leave tonight to Aguascalientes.
You can be in Mexico for a week?
I'm going to be in Mexico for just the week. I get back Monday morning.
Okay, but then you're going back.
I'll be here by enough time to... We land at 8 in the morning.
Right, but I'm saying you do have fights in Mexico. You're turning two guys pro next weekend.
Next, the 20th in Guadalajara.
And then you come back and it's Fresno. And
then it's Fresno, yeah.
Very busy times, good.
I love it, bro. I love it. See, this weekend is no fights, but I'm going to be with my wife, my son, and my daughter, and Aguascalientes. We're going to La Feria San Marcos. Nice. Have a good time. Enjoy some good fucking Palenque concerts. And then come back and then go to Guadalajara. I'm enjoying Guadalajara too. I can't wait for Guadalajara.
So last thing, remember, how do you like having Ryo in the gym? Everybody loves him. You know what I asked them? If they got a street fight, who they want? They say,
oh, Ryo. Everybody picks Ryo.
Why? He's from Seattle, man. He doesn't
The last fucking place where, oh yeah, he's from Seattle. So if he was from fucking Detroit or fucking Compton or something, we'd probably say he's Seattle, what the fuck do they? They don't even see the sun over there.
No, there's very bad areas, Robert.
Is it? Say. Arias cabronas, eh? In Seattle?
See? Yeah, no, very
it's
bad.
Like, it's like Milwaukee. The fuck do we, like,
well, we Milwaukee? Don't know, but
there might be some bad. And those in Seattle también?
Because NBA players told me that there's certain areas in town that are very rough, like Baltimore bad.
Yeah, like, see, you see, he's from Baltimore. Oh, he's fucking street. He's
gangster.
Seattle is kind of like, fuck.
You think about it,
we don't see it, but I'm pretty sure there is.
There is, for sure.
Hey, but you were born in Mexico,
Sinaloa.
You were born in Sinaloa?
No, but you don't come from Mexico.
No.
They see you like a pocho. That's
what
it is.
What age did you come here?
I grew up here at 3 years old.
So you speak fluent Spanish?
Yeah.
And English?
Yep. See, but it's crazy the way it is. Because even like Misael, like well, Misael hasn't been fighting, but Lindolfo, Mexican Olympian, born in Mexico, but he got an American promoter and he trains here.
He's not Mexican.
He's like a Mexican. He grew up in Washington, you know, trains and fights here in the United States, so they don't really see him like a Mexican.
But he was born there.
But yeah, but he was born. So was Lindolfo. But they don't see them like that. It's kind of fucked up.
For me, I would have to fight another Mexican with a lot of respect. And, you know, take that
beat him, and then
but you have to beat him because the crowd would be in the other guy's favor. Every time Lindolfo fights a Mexican, the crowd's against him.
I didn't know that
because they see him as the one. They see the other one as a real Mexican.
Maybe they don't know him. They just see him and they think
it's fucked up. No, but it's because he trains over here. He got a promoter from over here. This guy grew up over here, so it's even harder for him.
Did your dad box? An uncle? A grandfather?
No, my dad just always was a fan of. Boxing.
And he brought you to the gym?
Huh?
He brought you to the
gym? Yeah, he brought me to the gym.
And did you want to?
I was always fighting outside and stuff in the neighborhood, so.
Did you want to box?
Yeah.
Do you like it?
Yeah, he would tell me, like, He was threatening me, like, oh, you keep fighting, I'm going to take you to the gym. And I'll be like, let's go. And, yeah,
but you like the gym here, right?
Oh, I love it.
It's chill. It's a lot of people.
It's, you know, after next week, April, you know, since we have, like, all four guys, well, the three main guys, that, and then we have another one fighting on that same card, and then we got, like, four more fighting in Texas the same day, and one, and what's his name, Sosa, fighting Wednesday before.
The samurai, yeah.
So the gym, after that, Bam gets here, Rayo's gonna be here, so there's gonna be so much more time to focus, and, you know, we gotta, next 2 weeks,
it's gonna calm down.
The house very calm down, and we're gonna have more time to, you know, focus on helping Rayo and helping fucking everybody.
Rayo has a very big fight. He's gonna take care of business, and then Bam has a big fight. But it comes in waves, Robert.
Yeah, and since they're fighting, they're coming in pretty much at the same time. That's why it gets so crowded. But, you know, when if it wasn't for the show, we'd be having different times. You know, right now everybody shows up at the same time, so we have to be from one ring to another.
So, to end this interview, Robert, what's your message to your fans, people who love you and support you?
Well, they fucking always support me wherever we go, man.
They'll see you in Fresno.
Yeah.
They'll see you in Sinaloa.
They'll see me in Aguascalientes, too.
Aguascalientes.
This weekend.
Are you going to use a fake name? You know, sometimes he has to use a fake name in the lobby of the hotel because he doesn't want to be bothered. He says no.
No, I never do. Who does?
The worker told you your name. I thought you were going to have a fake name when you checked.
Yeah, but I don't.
NBA players have nicknames, like cartoon characters.
I was in Tijuana a couple years ago at a Palenque, Ramon Ayala, you know. So there was a kid right next to us. He was Mexican. So he comes up to me and tells me, and I had a few beers.
You're in a good mood, yeah.
I was in a good mood, listening to Ramon Ayala. So the kid comes up, hey, Robert, oh, shit, can I take a picture with you? Yeah, sure, fuck it, let's take a picture. He's like, you fought my dad. My dad was a boxer, and you fought him in the pros. I'm like, oh, yeah, what round did I knock him out? Because I couldn't say, did I beat him or anything? Because I lost to Ben Taki, Corrales, and fucking Casamayor. None of them were Mexican.
Yeah.
So I know I didn't fucking lose to your dad. So I'm like, oh yeah, what wrong did I not come out? I think I stopped him like in the fourth.
But it was really good.
But it was fun. Nah, he was cool. It was just, I was kind of tipsy already. So I told him, oh yeah, what wrong did I not come out? But, you know, I didn't lose to, I lost to Taki, who was African. Corrales was Mexican-American, whatever, you know. So he wasn't really Mexican. And Casamayor is Cuban.
But
so.
You were winning all those fights. I've watched
them. But it's just the way it is.
Casamayor is like a just cracked.
It happens in boxing,
bro.
But all that shit is learning experience, man. I think if I didn't go through those experiences, maybe I wouldn't be able to bring it to as a trainer. Because I know now that I've been smart enough to know if there's a cut before the fourth round and I know we're not winning, I'm going to stop the fight and go to no contest.
Smart.
And if I'm winning, I'm going to wait for the fifth round to stop it, to win on points. You know what I mean? I've done it so many times.
I
want to
make it clear, it's from accidental headbutt, guys. Don't be stopping a fight just because your guy has a cut.
Yeah, you know, so back then, you know, when I fought Casamayor, I think, like we said, if we were ahead on the points, I think I got cut and it was a hit, but back then if I would have stopped that, I probably would have won on points.
Yeah. He's a southpaw.
Because it was like in the sixth round.
Yeah.
So, but we didn't. No, we keep fighting. Then he stopped me like in the ninth round. He stopped me.
But small things like that.
Yeah, but small things. All that, I know right already, man.
But not only that, bro, you're expert now in negotiations. You're expert in contracts.
I know how to do that in the weigh-ins. I know how to fucking deal with the weigh-ins. I know how to fucking, fuck. I never done it. I haven't done it in a long time, but I know how to make guys make weight. I can't do it anymore.
No. One time me and him were with Chavez. I saw Chavez this week. Shout out from Chavez Jr. He's the best.
Chavez is good, man.
Up to 5 in the morning, 6 a.m. from midnight making weight. And he came down to like almost nothing, 0.2, 0.3.
Chavez
Jr. is the best. One of my favorite.
Yeah. And then he goes into the weigh-in and he missed it by point something. So everybody, pinche huevón. You know, because he didn't make weight.
He tried.
But I swear to God, he was like from 11 p.m. to 6 a.m. cutting weight. Duró like 7 hours cutting weight.
In the sauna, out the sauna.
Who was it? Was Arisa?
Era Arisa, me, Eli was there, Melena was there, right? So we know that's what happened.
He tried.
Pero llegó and he was point something. Pinche huevón, y que no le eche ganas. That motherfucker worked his ass off to try to make weight. Y luego the funny story is that I'm thinking point 2.3, you can make it. Let's go to your room, get into the fucking tub, and fucking point. You lose it in 10 minutes. Even we'll walk into the room, and he's like, hey, Robert, ¿cuánto es lo más que has pagado tú en un peleador tuyo que has pagado when they don't make weight? And I told him, well, Mikey, when he fought Juanma, Mikey didn't make weight, and he had to pay him $150,000. He's like, that's not a lot. Tell him I'll pay him $150. Así me dijo el cabrón. Diles que yo les pago 150. He was fighting Dorado Reyes.
Yes.
So I run back there to the commissioner. I said, he's not going to make weight. He wants to pay. They told me, oh, no, don't worry. Nacho Beristain already accepted $30,000. So fucking I saved him. I saved him, what, $120?
And that's why they gave you a bonus.
And that's why he gave me a bonus.
Yeah, Chavo's a good kid, man. Chavo's
like,
great.
I'll give him $150.
Yeah.
Why did a lot of fucking money.
Why did they take so much from Mikey? That's a lot.
It was the main event on HBO.
Juanma, right?
Juanma,
and
they
made
knew.
Juanma do Snow Angels.
Yeah, but Juanma knew that he had.
And after right that, there, Juanma never.
Or I saw him fight. That's what he could say. So he forced us to do it. You know what I mean?
All right.
Or else there was no fight. So he had. Mikey had to pay the $150.
Everybody that HBO did a 2 days on got sick. Everybody. They did one on Brandon.
Yeah.
Mikey, Triple G, I think everybody, that was a jinx, that 2 day show.
Good experience.
Yeah.
But it was funny because I fucking, we already took 30. Oh, fuck it, man.
Okay,
I saved
good.
Travis some money.
Why did they should have been a little more patient, but they were impatient.
They took 30.
But how did Nacho know he wasn't going to make weight?
No, because after he didn't make weight is when they negotiated.
Got it.
Walking to make weight. That's when. Then when I came back, they had already agreed to fucking to $30,000.
Okay, fine.
When Chavez was willing to pay $150.
That's amazing. All right, everybody, follow Robert at Garcia Boxing, at Ryu Boxing. Stay tuned, and of course, tune in April 27th on The Zone. Not pay per view. You can watch a fight. Yeah. Duarte, Virgil, and Jose Ramirez. Ellie Secbeck. Ripboarding, and you can follow me on Twitter at Secbeck. You can follow me on Instagram at Ellie Secbeck.